might have added too many chili peppers.
Hello there.
Oh, it's you. Goodbye, and welcome to Silly Bob Science. My name is Professor Silly Bob.
Professor, you have a PhD.
Yes, a PhD, a posh hot dog. Here at Silly Bob Science, we love to learn and carry out fun and interesting experiments. There's always something to learn from even the craziest of experiments. I recently learned that if you mix oil and water together, they throw you out the swimming pool. Most unfortunate. Today you find me working on my latest experiment. I'm trying to invent a solid version of water called brick water.
Silly Bob, solid water already exists.
It does? That sounds brilliant. I want to take a bath in it right now.
I wouldn't recommend it. Water only turns solid when it freezes. Solid water is better known as ice.
Ice! Of course! How silly of me to forget about something so obvious. It must have slipped my mind, probably because it's such a slippery substance. Ah, what could be better on a hot summer day than dropping a few ice cubes into your drink? Let me just isolate a few facts for us. Ice is just water that's been frozen into a solid state. That means it has been put somewhere really cold, like a freezer, or on one of the coldest parts of the earth, or near some of my dance moves. They're really cool! Ice exists all over the universe, on planets such as Mercury, or even in comets in space. And of course, ice exists here on Earth, where it occurs naturally all over the planet. The further north or south you go, the further the planet is from the sun, and the more snow and ice you'll find. Parts of planet Earth itself were shaped by the movement of ice in the form of giant glaciers, which shaped mountains during periods of time known as the Ice Ages. Oh, but that's just the tip of the iceberg. Ice is very slippery due to the top layer melting ever so slightly when pressure is applied to it. Because of this, ice can sometimes cause us problems. During winter months, ice can freeze over the roads, making cars slide around. Have you ever seen people putting salt onto the road when it's icy? I wonder why they do that. I feel an experiment coming on.
Remember, even Silly Bob knows you have to be safe when you conduct science experiments. Always wear protective equipment and have a responsible adult present.
For this experiment, we'll take a glass full of ice cubes. We're going to sprinkle some salt onto them. Then we will dip a piece of string into some water. We will lay the string on the ice, wait for a couple of minutes, and then lift the string. And look, a piece of ice is attached. The reason for that is that water freezes at a temperature of 0 degrees Celsius. And depending on how salty it is, salt water can be as low as minus 21 degrees Celsius before it freezes. So when we sprinkled the salt onto the ice, it dissolved into the water, melting the surface initially. However, some of the water then froze again, making it grip back onto the string.
So does that mean at 1 degree Celsius water is a liquid, but at 0 degrees Celsius it immediately becomes solid? That seems weird that 1 degree can make such a big difference.
Yep, 1 degree does make a difference. Check this out. We're going to do another experiment. Let's take a bottle of water. We're going to freeze it to 1 degree Celsius. That means we put it in the freezer for around about 2.5 hours. Now we take a glass full of ice cubes. So, when I pour this 1 degree Celsius water onto the 0 degrees Celsius ice, it will lower the temperature of the ice by 1 more degree and turn it solid. Ice can be used in lots of ways, like keeping food cold to preserve it, making ice rinks for people to skate on, or to make ice sculptures. I once made a spectacular ice sculpture. I left it in the garden on a nice sunny day for all the neighbours to see. When I came back later, it was gone. I think somebody must have borrowed it.
Professor Silly Bob, with your knowledge of science, do you think you could ever return me to my body?
Probably not, but I'll try. Thanks for joining me for my cool experiments. See you next time on Silly Bob Science. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, and tell your friends all about it. I'm Silly Bob. Hello!